The first round of votes are tallied in Alabama in the race to fill the Senate seat vacated by Attorney General Jeff Sessions. Former U.S. Attorney Doug Jones has won the Democratic primary, avoiding a runoff in a crowded field of seven Democratic candidates. But on the Republican side, former Alabama Chief Justice Roy Moore and Senator Luther Strange, who is temporarily filling Sessions' seat, will face off in the September runoff ahead of the December general election. And rescue workers and relatives are in a race against the clock, digging to find 600 people still missing in a mudslide in the West African country of Sierra Leone. At least 300 people died when mud and floodwaters surged through the capital city Monday. Hospitals officials say there that the morgue is overflowing with bodies. I'm Jackie Ibanez. Now back to Hannity for all of your headlines. Log on to FoxNews.com.
Do you think things have gotten worse or better since you took office?
I think they've gotten better or the same. Look, they've been frayed for a long time. And you can ask President Obama about that because he'd make speeches about it. But I believe that the fact that I brought in, it will be soon, millions of jobs. You see where companies are moving back into our country. I think that's going to have a tremendous positive impact on race relations. And I'll tell you, we're spending a lot of money on the inner cities. We're fixing the inner cities. We're doing far more than anybody's done with respect to the inner cities. It's a priority for me.
That was the president earlier today addressing this week's violence in Charlottesville and the overall state of race relations in the U.S. We continue more with former Speaker of the House, Newt Gingrich. Mr. Speaker, I watch the media that is just so openly hostile to him that it doesn't seem to matter anymore what he's going to say or do. And you have made this point many times on this program. But there's a pretty profound point there. If you look at the Obama years, I've given the statistics many times, 50 million Americans in poverty, 50 million on food stamps, 13 million more on food stamps after Obama, 8 million more in poverty after Obama, lowest labor participation rate. We now have a million new jobs. And what I hear the president saying is we fix the economy. We create an opportunity society. If we build in job creation and create wealth in a prosperity society, it goes a long way. If every American has their shot at the American dream, does that help race relations in America?
Well, look, I think you want to draw a distinction. I think that for the average African American, a better job, a safer neighborhood, a better school, greater opportunity to have a better future, I think that does help, and I think it helps bring us together as a people. On the other hand, there is an entire block of people now who want to use racism and left-wing ideology to deliberately, consciously split us. Now, many of these are in the elite media. They're doing it quite deliberately, and we have to have the guts to take them head on. And we have to point out that, you know, it was not President Trump's policies that led 4,000 people to get shot in Chicago last year. It wasn't President Trump's policies that have made Baltimore a nightmare in terms of people getting killed. What you've had is a decay in this country under left-wing policies that has led to dramatic depth of poverty, dramatic collapse of the law in some inner cities, and a sense of helplessness. I think Trump is the first real opportunity to begin to turn all of that around, starting by going after these renegade cities that refuse to get illegal criminals out of the city and refuse to cooperate with the federal government.
I'm not finished fake news. And the president calling out the media repeatedly today, when he said it, I just openly laughed out loud because they are so hostile towards him. And they, you know, all the times that he said, everything that he said about white supremacy and the people responsible for hatred this weekend, it has no impact on them. They actually were trying to make the case after he made the comments on fake news. Oh, he just repudiated everything that he's been saying all weekend. And I'm like, no, he didn't.
Right. Look, you made a point earlier that I really almost wanted to get into in the first segment, and that is the reason Obama was consistently wrong when he would get into these kind of problems is he took the view of the elite media, which is just wrong. The reason Trump is going to turn out to be right, and as I said, it's the American Civil Liberties Union, the ACLU, which has said he's right. They didn't say he's right, but they said it is correct to say that the violence in Charlottesville was on both sides. Now, Trump, because he doesn't rely on the New York Times, the Washington Post, CBS News, Trump is actually looking at reality. He's getting real reports from the Department of Justice, and he's also using his head. I mean, he's using common sense. And I think it's important to recognize that the elite media is in a frenzy to undermine him and, if possible, drive him from office in what really is a news media coup against the people of the United States who have elected him president. He's supposed to get 4 years in office, even if CNN doesn't like it or MSNBC doesn't like it. But they're going to do everything they can to isolate him, drive him down, and try to destroy him.
All right, Mr. Speaker, thanks so much for being with us. Appreciate it. When we come back today, President Trump called the driver who plowed his car into a group of people, killing one woman, called him a murderer. Laura Ingraham next.